Howdy everybody, Cub here. Welcome to the Let's Play. And today, guys, we got some pretty exciting stuff we're going to be building out on the opposite side of Zerazera in the jungle over there, close to our charged creeper. We're actually going to be building a functioning rocket this episode in preparation for 1.9. So this is going to be like how I can get to the top of the world to launch via Elytra once that comes out in 1.9. But first, I want to show you guys what we did during the live stream on Wednesday night. So, first thing we did is we actually took down the Christmas tree that was right here. So that is no more. It's all down. You can see we got the big zoomed out map here now. And also our more zoomed in map of our whole base area and Zerazera over here. So the place we're going to be putting this rocket is actually over here. So here's the charged creeper pixel art right here. So I'm thinking of putting this maybe like right here underneath my cursor, or maybe even over here in the jungle somewhere. So that way we have like a little place where we can launch from, and then we can just sort of fly over all of Zerazera here once 1.9 is out, and once we have Zerazera totally built. So that's what we're going to do later on. Let me show you some other things. We also got rid of out here. We got rid of the wreath that was here. So that's now gone on this side. And you probably have already noticed it, but we got rid of the red, white, and green Christmas colors along this elevator here. So that's pretty cool. We also added logs, these spruce logs here to spice it up a little bit. So we did that. We also changed the colors on these armor stands here. So these are now red and pink and white for Valentine's Day. Finally, we also added a pool table down here. Not here, this is the cart tracker here. But down here, in the bar area, pool table. See, we got our billiard balls in here. So we used firework charges and some other round objects like, you know, slime balls, clay balls right there. Surprisingly, there are a lot of objects that are actually round in Minecraft that we can use for this. And then, of course, you got your pool sticks right on there. And we used some hoppers for, like, the table legs and stuff. And I think it looks pretty great. And by the way, these are just signs here underneath here. And they sort of stick through just enough that you can think of them as pool cues. So yeah, built that on the stream. Thanks for everybody who joined on Wednesday night there. And so, we added a couple more things, which I'll show you out at the prison here. But first, I actually need to get in here. We need to gather a bunch of slime blocks. So let's see if we got plenty of slime blocks here. I'm gonna need some obsidian, which we're dangerously low on. Some of this right here. Let's see, we're gonna need some redstone, of course, some redstone blocks. We can use some of those, some repeaters, some torches, and a bunch of pistons, which I'm also gonna need to craft up. So I'll craft that stuff up, and I'll meet you guys out at the prison where we're gonna make a few more other minor changes. Take a look at what else we did during the live stream, and then we'll get out to the jungle. Alright, so just a few other things we did during the live stream. We went ahead and got some new horses here that we were missing. So we tested these out at the horse testing facility over there, which we'll see in a second as we run by it. But we got this horse here, not too bad, 10.5 meters per second speed, 2.5 jump height, and 9 hearts of health. And then we named this one. This is the fastest horse we got now, 13 meters per second. Jump height of 3 1/8 blocks and 10 hearts, and we named him Flash. If we can get in here, you can see that. Flash. There we go. Brown and black horse there. So yeah, we got 2 new horses in here. I think we got a horse now in every single stall. Just gonna check and make sure, yeah. No other ones have gone off or disappeared anywhere. Yeah, we're good. Donkeys in here, mules in there. Sweet. Okay, cool. Yeah, so the whole stable is now full. We have some other horses we still have to test out here just to make sure they could be faster potentially. So yeah, so we got a bunch on the edges there. So we'll have to test some of those in the future. But for right now, let's go and get on over to the prison. I'm going to go ahead and use some ender pearls here to get across. And we'll get over here. Yeah, this is the horse testing area right here. This basically just tests the speed. So you can run across this, like I'll just show you here. So our speed should be about 5.5 meters per second, I think. Let's see. Yep, 5.5 meters per second. That's the player speed when sprinting. And so, yeah, this basically measures horse speed up to 0.5 meter per second increments, all the way up from the 14.5. I think. Yeah, 14 and a half, and it goes all the way down to 4.5. So yeah, pretty nifty little system there. Hit the button to reset it. And the jump test is pretty straightforward. It just uses snow layers to test it here. As you can see, just a big jump test here. All there is to it. So, let's get on out here. So we also added some guards to the prison here. You can see up there, we got some guys in blue and black. Black cap, blue shirt, gray pants, and they actually have like brownish, blackish boots. And so there's one in that tower and one in this tower. And so that is what we did during the live stream. But today, guys, we're going to get out of here by the jungle, like I said, and build a rocket ship. So first thing I need, actually, is an axe. I think I left my axe out here from last time. Let's see. Where's my axe? There's an enchanted bow. Here it is. Forest harvester, yeah. That's what we're going to need, because we're going to be harvesting this forest quite a bit in one area, I should say. So, my idea for this thing is this. So, I've talked about this a little bit on the channel. Basically, I want to make a reusable rocket, because in all honesty, that's the future of rocketry. If you guys know SpaceX and Blue Origin, those are two companies, real companies in real life, that have been focusing on rocket reusability recently. And they have rockets that can go up, deliver payloads to orbit in SpaceX's case, or yeah, just go up for like a good time, basically, in Blue Origin's case. And then come back and land safely on Earth. So that's what I want to do with this Minecraft rocket. So we're going to have to make a rocket that can go both up and down. And I also want it to launch out of like a silo. So like we get into it, like we go underground, there'd be like a trap door that opens up, we launch up all the way up to the world height, and then I can like start, I can like jump off up top up there and then fly over Zara over here once it's complete over here. So this hall is going to be filled with stuff from Zara. You can see the roads come all the way out here. There's a road going across there. So there's going to be a lot of stuff here. Eventually. It does take a little bit of time to build because I am doing all this in survival, vanilla survival Minecraft. But I think it should be worth it, and I want to get this thing up so we can be ready for 1.9 and yeah, use it as sort of like an elytra launcher. Now, let's see. So here's the creeper right here. I'm thinking maybe, let's see how close we are to the desert over here, because there's, I want to have somewhat of a buffer here, so like you're not going to be able to see this from the desert. Because this is going to have buildings, there's going to be a big wither temple here, etc. Probably going to do something with this wall here. Could even build it over there. That might be a little too far away, though. Let's build it in here somewhere. Sort of in like a secluded jungle area back here. Yeah, I'm thinking right here would be nice. Like right on this lake. This lake shore. It's not too far away, but it's also kind of hidden back a little ways. Maybe even back even further, like back here. Let's see, maybe over here. This looks like a nice flat spot over here. Yeah, this actually looks pretty ideal right here, right next to the lake. This is already fairly clear. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and cut down the trees in this area. So just go ahead and cut these down, wait for these leaves to decay, because we want a nice flat area to build this in. I think what I need to do is, after we're done cutting these down, we have to dig out a big hole here. It's going to be probably about a 4x4 or 5x5 hole, and we'll have like a trap door on top, so the rocket can like launch out. So I think this should be a pretty decent spot here. Yeah, I think this will be pretty good. So let me go ahead and just clear all this wood out, all these leaves out, and stuff like this, and then we'll start to dig down. Okay, guys, so we went ahead and cleared out a bunch of jungle here, and I also went ahead and dug down two more blocks in the area that we cleared. And that's because we need that area for the 4x4 trapdoor redstone here, which is going to be pretty redstone intensive to open that amount of blocks. And yeah, we also started putting down the design for the landing pad here. The design we're going to use is actually the SpaceX logo, which you can see here. So the SpaceX logo is white, has a white background. And then there is blue, which we're going to use just blue wool here for the X in the SpaceX. So yeah, it should be pretty cool. Should be pretty good. The 4x4 trapdoor itself is going to be actually inset one block, because otherwise we couldn't hide the redstone. And yeah, we got to hide the redstone, otherwise it's going to be ugly. So let's go ahead and actually start this build right now. So as I mentioned, this square is 16 blocks by 16 blocks. So that means we need the 4x4 to be 6 blocks from every side. So let's just start counting here. So we got 1 here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And on the 7th block, we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. And then we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from there. Good. And we come out 3 more. 3 there. And then we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from that side. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from this side. Perfect. Okay. So our 4x4 is going to be right there. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Okay, cool. So, now what we need some sticky pistons placed down. So we're just going to go ahead and place some sticky pistons down like this. And then on this side over here, like that. And then we'll do the same thing on this side. If I can get up here, place some down facing inward, just like that. Very nice. And so these four pistons here and these four pistons on this side, these are all just going to pull back this entire row here. And these pistons will be sort of like the ones that do the work next to the 2x2, which we're going to put down in a second here. These will basically catch, let's see, it'll be this block and this block. So yeah, this block will go to there, this block will go to there. So that's how this is going to work here. Just go ahead and get on back up here. I need to place down another sticky piston facing this direction right there. And then we just need our 2x2 double piston extenders. So let's just grab those. Let's see. We're going to need to have those here and there. So let's just go ahead and do that and that, that and that. Same thing over here. So we'll need there, there, and there, and there. Okay, cool. So that is our sticky piston layout. Let's go ahead and start with the redstone now. All right, so we now have our pistons all laid out, and we're ready to start some of the redstone here. My input is actually going to be this button right here, which is going to open up the 4x4 trapdoor. I will also note that this is not my design. This is a design by a guy called Zombachu on YouTube. I'll provide a link to his channel in the description so you guys can check out how to build this for yourselves if you want to. But my input's going to come down here, go right into this block here, at which point we're going to have a redstone torch here and here. And we're going to go ahead and place block there, redstone torch on this. Then we're going to need a T flip-flop. So we're going to use the hopper-dropper type of T flip-flop. So let's see, we're going to have dropper right here, dropper facing out, and then hopper facing back in. We're going to place down an item, let's just say stone, right in there. And now what we'll need is a comparator. This comparator will go right there. We'll have a block here with a redstone repeater right there. And then blocks all along here like that. Now we're also going to have to place dust all along here. And then tricky part is putting all these redstone torches on these pistons. And now we got to bust our way out. There we go. Beautiful. Let's put that back. Fantastic. Okay. So you can see that this row of four will basically pop out and then push back. Pretty straightforward there. Next thing we got to do is wire up the double piston extender here. And these sort of, I don't really know what to call this. The one that hides the side one here, this one. So this block's going to be pulled back and then pulled back by this piston here. So to do that, we're going to go ahead and make a monostable with a dropper right here and hopper. And then we're going to need block in here. Just get out some stone bricks. Place down a comparator right here. Block. Peter on two ticks. It's going to go into a block here with a torch. And then we're going to need another monostable, except this time it's a little bit different. We're going to have a non-stackable item in there, just because we need the additional signal strength here. That's going to have a hopper right there. Block here, we're going to have a comparator coming out this direction, and basically this is going to go and power these like that. Very nice. And then we'll also need, yeah, torch there, torch right there. Now from here we're going to have repeater on three ticks right here. It's going to power a dust right there. And then same thing over here. We'll have a repeater right here on three ticks, powering a dust right here. Very nice. Sweet. So basically, this is how we're going to power these once this block is removed. That's basically what's going on here. Then we're also going to need a torch here, blocks here, and we'll need a dust and a repeater on four. So yeah, this will basically give this enough time to get out there, pull back, and this will reach out and grab the block. And then, yeah, same thing over here. We'll have a torch here, blocks here. We'll have dust here, repeater on four here, and we also need a torch here and here. Very nice. Okay, so now we can just basically punch these out, put these back, and that side is now done. Actually, both these sides are now pretty much done. Now we got to work on this side and the other side. Okay, so for this, what we're going to need is we're going to need to come on down here. We're going to make a, basically a something that activates every time instead of every other time, like this this hopper dropper T flip-flop, basically. So to do that, we're going to place a piston right there. We're going to place a block of redstone here, torch on here, and then another hopper dropper thing right here. So hopper dropper, we'll go ahead and place a item into there, and then place a block down here, and then it's basically going to be the same as before, same as what we had before. So we're going to need block here, and we're going to have a torch here, two blocks here, dust here, and yeah, redstone torches on those blocks. Now we just need the same timings we have over here, essentially. So what that means is we're going to need blocks here and here. Gonna need a block on this side, not up there. Block on this side right here. And then, yeah, again, blocks here and here. So for this one, we're gonna have three ticks, dust. This one's dust and four ticks. Now on this side, basically the same thing. We just have three ticks here, dust. And then this one actually needs four ticks and then two ticks because it doesn't have the torch here. And yeah, that's basically it. We just now need the redstone torches underneath of the pistons. And then we can just do the same thing, break these off and place these back right here. So that should now be able to close. And now we just have to wire up this side and make it open. So we're going to go ahead and wire up the four pistons over here now. Should be pretty straightforward. So just take your sticky pistons, and on the first torch we place down on the right side of that initial block, we're going to place down sticky piston. Then we're going to need a redstone block right here, sticky piston on that, and that's basically going to hold a block here, which will get powered, and we'll have this, let's see, we want to have this have a repeater on it. Go into a block with a torch on it, and this is basically going to power another T flip-flop here. So, yeah, repeater right there. Then we'll just make our dropper-hopper combination right here. So, droppers and hoppers right there. And then just the same thing we did on that side. So we just have comparator here, block here with a repeater, and then some dust on top of blocks here. And on the other side, we got our torches. See if I can actually hit this. No, I can't. Dang it. I got to drop down. Got to drop down and piston in my face. There we go. Okay, let's see if we can pearl out. But that should be it besides placing down the item in here, which will go right there. Very nice. Okay, so this side will now open. You see it's extended like this side. And now, yeah, we just have to get the opening sequence for these double piston extenders. Okay, so this is where the design gets really, really clever, in my opinion, at least. So we're going to take a redstone torch, place it down right here. Then we're going to place some droppers in a sort of a counterclockwise fashion here. So there'd be one there, one here, and then a hopper facing downward directly into there. And yeah, we can basically now put one item in here, and we'll take a signal from this hopper. So we'll place block down here, get a comparator out. I'm sorry, not here. One block over. So it's going to be like this. So we'll take a comparator signal out of there. It'll go into here and then into a repeater on four ticks right there. So that is basically the opening right there for this side. And then we'll do a similar thing on this side. So we're just going to extend this down a little ways and add a little more redstone on this side. And let me just clear out this area here real quick. So for the opening of the double piston extender on this side, we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dust right here. And then we're going to make a little bit of another little clever hopper dropper system right here. So this goes over, comes up, and then we need a little bit more hopper action. So let me get another hopper here. I need a crafting table. So let's just make this real quick here. Put that down there. Chest, iron. And there's our other hopper. Very nice. Okay. Cool. So we come over here. Yeah, we'll place hopper going directly down there. And then one going over right there. And we'll place an item. Like I said, doesn't matter what it is. We'll put stone in there. It goes into there. And from here, what we're going to do is now take out a signal from this hopper right here. It's going to go into a block here. And then here we're going to have four ticks of delay. Block right here, and then a block right here with dust on it, and that should basically be it. Only thing we have left to do is actually to grab some immovable blocks. I'm just going to use obsidian here, and we'll put immovable blocks behind these corner pistons, the ones that grab these blocks here. So let's just go ahead and do that right now. And the reason is because these are being butted, so we don't want these to one bud just before the other one and then push this piston out or something like that. So that's why we got to do that. But that is it pretty much, I think. Yeah. So, I think we can now test it out. Let me just go ahead and sleep through the night here so we don't get visited by any sort of mobs here. Okay, there we go. And, all right, let's test it out. So, 3, 2, 1. Ta-da! Alright, so there we go. It's open. You know, you can obviously, 4x4, now open. let's go ahead and just jump on out here. Make sure it closes properly. There we go. Okay. Let's see it close. There we go. Cool. Yeah, and it has a really nice animation, as you see. So it pulls back, sides pull back, and the sides pull back again. And then when it closes, sides push out first, and then the double pistons push out twice. So, yeah, pretty sweet. Pretty sweet design, I gotta say. So, yeah, that is good. That is our 4x4 now done. So, now the only thing we have left to do is cover this thing up. So I'm just going to grab my blocks of iron. And we're basically going to cover this entire thing here. And we'll also grab our blue wool, because we want to make the X design here. I think what we're going to have in the center here is actually something like this. We'll have like the blue wool here and in the corner blocks like this. And this one and this one like that. And then we'll just sort of like go from there. So like the X will keep going out and out here. And out to there on this side, and then on this side, similar type of deal here. So just come down like this and then over. Make sure nothing falls in, otherwise it could affect the design here. Get some more blue. So there's that. And yeah, but you can sort of get the idea here, and then we'll just fill in this with iron blocks. So it will be a little bit depressed here in the center, but it's necessary to hide all this redstone. But I think you sort of get the idea here. So I'm going to go ahead and continue to cover this up, and we'll test it out once more to make sure it works. Okay, guys, so I added on a little bit to the landing pad, added some blue stained clay in there as well to go along with the basic blue wool. And, yeah, it doesn't look too bad. You got the little inflection on the X, like the SpaceX logo has up here as well. So it sort of, you know, tails off to the right there. But let's go ahead and get down and see if this works. I think it should. Hopefully it still does. Hopefully I didn't inadvertently cut off any redstone anywhere. Well, here we go. 3, 2, 1, open. All right, let's see. Looks like that opened pretty well. Yep, 4x4 is now open. Let's see it close. And it's closed. Okay, so sweet. Still works. Very nice. Okay, good deal. So let's go ahead and open it up now. And what we need is we need now a space to put this rocket. So we're going to have to sort of think about how we're going to build this, because we can't put any immovable blocks along the sides, so no slime block can touch the sides of this. But I don't think that should be a problem, but yeah, we have to build it in a way so that that doesn't happen. So I'm just going to come on down here. I think I want to make this out of mostly iron blocks here like this. So all around like this, and like that. And it'll be mostly iron going all the way down, pretty much. So let me get some ladders too. I gotta come out here. Yeah. Right out there. There we go. We'll get some wood, craft up some ladders, and we'll get started on digging out this middle area down here. Alright guys, so we got the entirety of our area dug out down here, and I put just iron blocks around here. You'll see we got a little bit of extra area over here. That's for some redstone we have to put down later on. But let's go ahead and actually start to build this rocket. The rocket design I'm going to use is by JL Gaming. So you guys can check him out. Link in the description once again. But this is the only one I found that was both resource intensive or resource friendly. That can be built in survival, although with quite great difficulty, especially for the top part we still have to build. And yeah, also, yeah, would fit through this 4x4 here. So we're going to go ahead and start with by placing down obsidian, a movable block right here. This rocket itself is going to be 11 blocks tall, by the way, just so you know. And so then we're going to need a sticky piston, or no, a regular piston, slime block. And this is going to be kind of challenging to build. Let's see, we're going to need sticky piston facing downward now. So we're going to need something like this, sticky piston facing downward. And then what we're going to do is we're going to need a piston, regular piston, facing up. And like I said, this is going to be kind of challenging for me here. Just get this down. There we go. So then, again, regular piston facing upward, slime block. And then we're going to need a sticky piston facing downward, if we can get this. This is where the tough part comes in. Let's see if we can just do this. Sticky piston facing downward. There we go. Beautiful. Okay. Next level. Gonna need... let's see. What are we gonna need? Regular sticky piston facing upward. Slime block. An air block. And then... on this level here, we'll need a regular piston facing downward. And that's going to be the top right there. Perfect. Okay, good. Now what we'll need is on this side to extend these slime blocks. And we're actually also going to place a redstone block on top right there. Let's go ahead and get down here. We'll need a redstone block. Actually, one right there, one right here. One right here, one right here. And if I can get this out, there we go. One right here, one right there, one right there. Okay, so that's all the redstone blocks and the slime blocks we need. I might actually have to extend this a little bit just so we can get all the redstone in, but now let's go ahead and do the redstone. So I extended this out a little bit here, and we're going to use that to our advantage here. So let's just go ahead and we'll place down some obsidian here. And right here, and we're gonna go ahead and place down a non-sticky piston just like that right there. And if I can actually get out here, place one down right there. Perfect. Okay, sweet. And then we're gonna go ahead and do the same thing up here on this side. So let's just get up here, and we're gonna place down a block here and piston in this way, if I can get this down correctly. No. Okay, let's try this. There. Perfect. Okay, good. So, let's see. I think I'm going to go ahead and raise this up a little bit further even. We also need to go ahead and place down a block here, and then go up two blocks, another block right there. Just get rid of these other two right here, and this one, and we need a sticky piston here, and up on that block. Very nice. Cool. Okay. So now we can go to our start here, this point right here, and let's just make another one of these right here. So this is going to be where we sort of launch off from. I'm just going to go ahead and move these torches here. Put some torches around so that nothing spawns down here. There we go. Torches in various spots. Looks like we got one more block up here we got to replace. If we can get up there. There. Okay. Perfect. And we're going to start wiring this from right here. So I'm going to go ahead and place down a button right on here. And we'll start to wire this thing up. Okay, so from this point, a redstone signal is going to come from this block, so we're going to take it down one block here. So it's going to be on this block. Place dust on there, and then we'll go ahead and place block down here, and then we got to get up there, of course. So let's just go ahead and drop on in here. We'll place a redstone repeater down right here, block right here, and then this block's going to go up here. We'll place dust there and there. And we're also going to power down here by placing dust there and there. So that'll power this piston and this piston. Move these redstone blocks over here. So when we want to go up, that's what'll happen. Also, on this other side here, let me just get back up here. It's getting a little crowded. Let's see if we can get over here. Yeah, okay. Right here, we're going to have another redstone repeater right down here. It's going to go into a block. Right there. And we got to power these pistons here. So this one, we're basically going to do something like this. We're going to have dust. We'll have block. And then a block. Oh, man. Tough. Block here. This repeater here is going to be on two ticks. And then down here, we'll have it come straight across. To, let's see, here, maybe? Yeah, right here. And yeah, we'll have repeater right here going this direction on three ticks. There we go. Can barely make it there. Dust back there. Dust right there. Okay. And now we got to get up there one more time. Got to get the very topmost piston. Right. So from here, this will come up like this. And we're going to need some slabs. I'm just going to use these stone bricks. So we're going to have it go up, up, up. And then finally it'll come over like this. And so we're going to have dust across here and all the way down this staircase pattern. Just like that. Nice. All right, so that's it. That's the whole bottom part done. And yeah, you can see here, there'll be a one block gap between the slime blocks and any wall, so there'll be a one block gap there, one block gap here, and I think it's actually a two block in the back. Yeah, and these redstone blocks will also miss, so nothing should go wrong with this, I don't think. So now we gotta test it out. So basically what that means is we gotta jump on this very top piston, this thing, and go all the way up to world height just by simply towering up like this. So I'm going to make sure I have some obsidian up there. I do. Good. Okay. So I'm going to tower all the way up to world height, place an obsidian down, and then come all the way back, destroy this tower on my way back down, and then, yeah, hopefully not die, and we'll test it out to make sure it goes up, and then we can build the upper part. Okay, so we're getting kind of close to the top now. We should be able to hit the very tip top of the world. And yep, right here, this is the highest spot, so we're gonna break one right there, place an obsidian down right there, and now we can't place anything else down. Let's now go ahead and place some dirt. Gonna place a dirt two blocks down, jump off. Place another dirt a little further down. Break that one, and now take this down and hope we did everything correctly. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and take this down, and hopefully this thing will stop at the top up here. So this thing should be good to go now, actually. You can see the obsidian block way up there in the sky. And this thing's ready to ride, actually. So we just stand on this block, hit this button, and we should go up, and hopefully we don't get caught or didn't make a mistake somewhere, but we're about to find out. Yeah, so here we go. The inaugural flight of the rocket. What should we call it? What should we call our rocket? Redstone? That's an actual rocket name from NASA, actually. They called a couple of their rockets Redstone in the past. So yeah, that's good. That's a good name. Appropriate, as it's made of redstone blocks. Okay, here we go. 10. No, I'm just kidding. All right, 3, 2, 1. Wish me luck. Liftoff. All right, here we go. Yes. It's getting F5 here. Yes. It's working. It's working. Oh my god. Okay. It's gonna be a minute here till we get to the top. But yeah. We'll try to see how this kind of goes. Looking pretty solid right now, I gotta say. Everything working well. Haven't glitched through the block, but yeah, long, long way to go to the top. So we started off... What did we start off at? We started off at, like... Something like Y equals 64 or so. We're going all the way up to 200 plus. Way up there. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see. It looks like we're pretty consistent so far in terms of not falling through. So that's good. We'll just ride this out and see how far we can get. Hopefully all the way to the top. I think we should be able to get all the way to the top. But once at the top, we gotta make some more redstone stuff, so... Yeah, looks like we're about... How far are we there? Almost half... A little over halfway there, actually. Let me switch out of F5. Here's the view right here, by the way. Well above the height of the pixel art, creeper pixel art. You can see how big the lightning bolt is there. You can see some parts of there, some of the roads. There's our charged creeper farm right there. Some other stuff down there, maybe you can see. You can probably see my house from here. If we had 32 render distance, 32 chunk render distance. All right, we're getting close now. Getting very close. This is it. Will it stop? I think it's looking like it's aligned. I think we did it, guys. Yes, we did it. We're up here now. 251. 251 is the height we got. The eagle has landed. The eagle has landed. Okay. We got a little bit more redstone we got to put up here now. So let me get out of F5 and we'll start to put this stuff down. Alright, so basically we're up here now at Y equals 251. And yeah, obviously if I fell from this height, I would definitely die. But this is actually me in post-editing right now, talking over some of the footage. Basically because this took a long time to build. I will have the entirety of this up on my second channel, sort of like a long version of this episode if you want to see it, on Cub Fan Games. There'll be a link in the description to that channel. So go and check that out if you want to see the entirety of this. But just know here I'm just building the reverse of what I built on the ground. So instead of shifting the blocks, the redstone blocks to the right, shifting them to the left. You see a misplaced piston there. And same whenever we have one that was going to the left, we switch it to the right. So that's all I'm doing here, and we're going to pick it back up at nighttime when I'm placing down the redstone. So for the redstone dust here, we're going to do the following stuff. So let's just place a block down there that we can, yeah, easily move. I'm going to place down redstone dust right there underneath of our button. Now we're going to place dust here and here into that obsidian right there. I'm going to break that torch, which is going to send us into total darkness. That's okay, though. Let's go ahead and get back up here this way. Gotta break those two blocks. Let's go ahead and place dust from here, going into this obsidian here. It'll come up here, over to here, Actually, we need a repeater on this point. Let's just go ahead and place down a torch there. I don't think that affected anything, although it may have. Son of a gun. Well, we'll see. We'll see. Okay, so then repeater here. 3 ticks. And we'll have a block right here. Right there. Very nice. Okay, and then we need dust on this side. So dust, dust, dust into that obsidian right there. And dust on top too. There. Okay, good. Next up, we need some more slabs. So let's see. Basically, what we need here is this. So we need a block. So let's just make this iron. So we need iron block. Iron block. And we need to connect this with slabs here. So let's put slab there, although this needs to be lower by one. There we go. So there's our first slab. Second slab will go up a little higher to here. Right there. And then this will connect up here, and then this goes into a repeater on 4 ticks. And that should be it, maybe. If that update there didn't cause any issues. Just try that. Maybe that fixed it. Who knows? All right. I'm going to try and write this down. We'll see what happens here exactly. But I think I got this wired up correctly. I'm actually going to place down a few more blocks here. So we have a little platform up here to stand on. I don't think I see any other blocks that need to be moved or anything. Yeah, I think we're good, actually. So let me place down this torch here. Okay, so here we go. Moment of truth. Let's see if the down function works. Hopefully. Nope. Son of a gun. Am I going to survive this? No, I'm not. I'm dead. Okay. And I should move. Yep. Okay. Well, this has been a disaster. Let me get back up there and see what went wrong. Dang. Snap. I can't fight this guy right now either. Yep, that happened. So we know that this one down here works. I couldn't get it to work on the top by modifying it, so I'm just going to rebuild it down here and then launch it up. And then once it's up there, we'll go ahead and climb up that ladder right there you see and test if it comes down once again. So I'll be back once we are ready to test it coming back down. Okay, so we're up here now with the reconfigured mechanism, with the reconfigured blocks and everything. So I think this should now work going down. I hope it will. If not, I don't really know what to do. So everything is all set. We got the right delay on the repeaters. I'm going to risk it and just stand on it and see what happens. So here we go. Okay, yeah. Appears to be working. Let's go into F5. Nice. Yeah. This is what was supposed to happen the first time. Okay. Good deal. Okay, see, we got the ladder there. Let's just jump off this. Watch it go down. Yeah. Seems to be working now. Let's make sure it goes in down here easily. I think it should. Alright, here we go. Perfect. Slides right in there just like so. Okay, guys, so we went ahead and redid some stuff here. We got the silo door closed now, as you can see. We also removed this button, and we put it down here in this new section. So this is sort of a tunnel that leads all the way over to our rocket. Very nice. Okay, so see the silo doors are now closed. We need to open these if we want to launch, which is what we're going to do here. So silo doors are now open, and we are ready to go. So, can I get a countdown, please?
15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour.
And there we go, guys, all the way up to the top here. And once 1.9 comes out, we can just simply run off this with the elytra, and that will be that. Essentially, yeah, we just start flying down towards Zerazer, which is over in this direction. You can't quite see it because we're so high up. But then we just get in the same rocket and go on down. And another perfect touchdown, guys. So, then we just simply hit this button. Close the silo door. I might just have it so that once this thing gets in position, it automatically closes it. That would be kind of useful to have. But I think that's going to be all for me today, guys. Very happy we got this rocket up to world height. Up and down rocket. So, yeah, basically when we use the elytra, we just go up and then hit the button so it comes down. Yeah, it travels all the way down. And then we just fly off with the elytra is sort of the idea. So yeah, we might have to add that functionality where it just automatically closes by itself. So that way we could just hit the button, it would come down, close this off, and be ready for us to come back when we launch again. So guys, hopefully you enjoyed this episode. I very much enjoyed making this. And yeah, thank you guys for all of you who suggested that. That was a viewer suggestion. Many people suggested that, actually. And yeah, if you guys want to see other cool stuff with this, you know, we could put like a player launcher up there maybe with TNT to make us go even higher with the Elytra, or maybe a space station up there. Something cool like that. We'll figure something out. And once again, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Cub. Goodbye.